Hey guys, welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to draw a cartoon face based on a reference. I'll show you my process and you can draw along with me as always or create your own character. And my process is in no way a realistic representation of the reference. Instead, I like to create an original character and just loosely base it on my reference photo. So without any further ado, let's get started. So I've chosen a photo from Pinterest as my reference. You can see it here. And I just opened the reference window in Procreate and put it on the left side. I use my favorite sketching brush, which is Edge 2.0 brush. I will link it in the description. I take a light color and start to sketch a base for my character. It's just a simple drawing, like a circle, then I add the chin, cheeks, I create a base for the eyes and nose, like the central lines of the face where I'm gonna put the features. And we will not focus on drawing the body here or hands, so I will draw a simple body, but it's not. Anyway, I'll just draw a simple representation of the body. I start to draw the hair just very loosely. I erase an ear because it will be covered by the hair, and I just create like a few strands of hair very loosely, not focusing on details at this stage. It should be very, very rough. I don't actually copy the reference. I mean, neither the face nor the hair. I just try to see some interesting strands of hair that I can copy, and actually I just make some random strokes. Then I draw the shape of the eyes. Usually I make the eyes pretty big. That's what I like to do in my style. I draw a small nose, also just the indication, a small oval, and the lips. So here how I'm gonna put the features, again roughly, because I can change it at any point and you will see that I will do it, definitely. And the eyelashes. Now it doesn't look pretty, but you'll see that when I start to refine it, it will be better. I draw the eyebrows. And what I like to do is to flip my canvas, and then I can see what I can fix with the liquify tool, and then I put it back. It seems fine as a rough sketch. I create a new layer, lower the opacity of the previous one, and with a darker color and the same brush, just make it a little bit smaller, I start to refine the sketch. I often start with the eyes, because for me it's the most important part of the face. I like to draw really big eyes. And yeah, usually I start with them and then I place the other features, and I do all of that on different layers. So the eyes will be on a separate layer, the nose, the mouth, and so on. So this way it's easy to control and I can move things around if I don't like how they're placed. So it's very useful for me. When the first eye is done, I just duplicate it, flip it horizontally, and place it in its place. Yes, I'm lazy. I just prefer to do that because this way they look symmetrical. But I only do that in a profile view. I only do it in the front view, right? Because this way the eyes are kind of symmetrical. Then I refine the eyebrows. And then I use the transform tool to fix the eyebrows and to lift them a little bit. Because in my style, I also like to put the eyebrows higher than they're supposed to be. Then I draw the nose. I just look at my reference to see the shapes roughly, but it will not be exactly the same, and then I'll make it a bit smaller as well, so it's pretty different from the reference anyway. Make it smaller and put it a bit lower. Then I create a new layer and start to draw the mouth, the lips. I try to make them a little bit similar to the reference photo because the shape is really interesting. I like to put some shadow on the upper lip because usually when you have the light source from above, the upper lip will be darker than the lower one, and this mouth is way too big, so I make it smaller. And I also make the nose a bit smaller. Also, I see that the eyes are too big as well. I make them a little bit smaller. And then I start to draw the face itself. I use the liquify tool a lot to fix things at this stage. That's why I draw things on different layers. So it's much more comfortable to fix, let's say, just the face or just the eyes. draw the ear, and I want it to be a little bit bigger than it's supposed to be, and then it's on the reference. I like to draw ears bigger than they are. Yeah, I think it's too big, so let's make it a bit smaller. Draw the hair. So I start with the fringe or the bangs, right? And I really like this reference because of the hair mostly. So I just try to replicate some strands of hair that I see here. Not exactly, of course, but somewhat similar. And now it's really huge, as I can see, so I'm gonna make it smaller in a while. Because her bangs are really short in the photo and I wanna keep it that way. So with the transform tool, I can make them shorter. Then I draw the rest of the hair, and I like to draw this kind of cute hair on top. I think I always do that, I don't know why, but I think it looks cute, so. And then I try to draw different separate strands of hair. When I draw curly hair, I always do that. I think it looks more natural because this you can see the strands separately usually, not unlike the straight hair. So I just make some random lines and see if they work. Basically, that's my process for drawing hair. I'm not really thorough or particular about this, so I just draw some random hairs here and there. Also, I like to draw different loose strands of hair. They give more personality and movement to the face or drawing. So yeah, just try to draw some strands and see if it looks good. If it does, keep it. If it doesn't, erase and draw another one. So that's how I do it anyway. I lower the opacity of my first layer just to see what I'm doing better. And as always, I flip my canvas horizontally and I can see like how I drew the body. It's not really straight, so I can fix that. I can fix the ear a little bit, the face, and yeah, the body, the shoulders and neck. I also make the neck a little bit thinner. And I also fixed the eyes. They were not on the same level before. Yeah, I think it looks good. So I'm just gonna make a few small changes to the face. But all in all, I think it's done. So basically, that's my process for drawing a face, a cartoon face. And usually what I do next is create a clean line art. Here I'm not gonna do that, just for the sake of time. But yeah, I make a clean line art and then I color it and so on. So thank you for watching this tutorial. I hope you liked it, guys. And if you did, like this video and subscribe to my channel. That means a lot to me. And let me know in the comments what kind of videos you'd like to see on this channel. I really appreciate that. And thank you, guys. See you in the next video.